Hi guys, I've had some people message me about the new Strobeck video that has just come out called Stallion. I have watched it and I have a few things that to say, I suppose. This whole video takes place in Milan in Italy. I think I have a couple of things that sort of stuck out to me. Pretty good Supreme montage, I will say. There's some nice tricks in here. One of the things that I think I find to be a little weird about Strobeck videos is the weirdest thing in this video, I think, is this intro where he's kind of filming this dude like he's Strobeck's boyfriend and they're on vacation, and this is just like some kind of B-roll with his shirt off. I'm not trying to hate on it or anything, but there is something very homoerotic about a lot of the way that Strobeck chooses to document certain dudes. And I don't think it really comes from a place like that. You see what I'm saying? It kind of sounds like he's on vacation and this is his like boyfriend and he's just filming him frolicking at the beach or something. But I don't think it's supposed to come off that way. I just think that he really likes skateboarding and has a specific, maybe, a fascination with each person that he films. And something about this guy, I think, has struck his interest in particular. Another thing that I kind of notice about this is I feel like Strobeck's filming has gotten so formulaic. It's getting in the way sometimes when in like a freestyle situation like this where the camera ends up whipping around a lot because he doesn't know what's happening next. So he wants to film the head, go back up, film the head again, but it turns out he's going to do another trick, so he goes back down. And it's just like, when you start to notice it, like how he films every clip sort of the same way, I think it can wear on you a little bit. And I think it's more evident in a little bit of a looser situation like this one than it is in most of the montage. But I think some of his, like there, do you know what I mean? It's a little bit, it's just so predictable that I think at times it works against him. Do you know what I'm saying about this sort of slightly homoerotic vibe going on? Again, nothing wrong with that. Just an observation, that's all. But yeah, I think personally this style of sort of romanticizing the skateboarder, it doesn't resonate with me, I think, in the same way that it resonates with some other people. I think this has a very profound effect on younger skateboarders. The magic of like skateboarding and talented skateboarders is something to be enthralled in. And personally, I don't really have that sort of fascination with like these teenagers. I'm an adult, and so me watching these videos, I'm kind of more here for the skateboarding. I'm not really here to develop a crush on any of these guys, a man crush or a romantic crush, anything like that. I'm more here for the skateboarding. So these long-winded, sexy intros, they're not really my thing. This intro kind of, it didn't do much for me, and it sort of felt like a bit of a waste of time for me personally. Not saying it's a bad intro or anything. I just don't think this is really the kind of thing that is designed for somebody like me. And I'm careful to frame a lot of these criticisms in a way where I don't want it to sound like I am blatantly hating on what Strobeck does, what Supreme does, what FA does, or what Hockey does, anything sort of in that universe, because I think it's very easy for people to hate on it without good reason. And that's because I think it's popular, it's very trendy, and personally, I think that I understand the reasons why these kinds of videos are popular and trendy. They have a knack for picking really talented skateboarders and really cool skateboarders. People will just hate on Sean Pablo. I hear so much hate towards Sean Pablo, and personally, I don't really understand it. I think he's a really talented skateboarder. To some people, the fact that his bag of tricks isn't super deep or something is a problem, but you know, how I look at it is do I like watching the guy when he's on the screen? I mean, speaking of Sean Pablo, he doesn't show up on the screen once in this montage. He must have been busy doing something else, or maybe he's hurt. I don't know. That's mostly how I gauge the skateboarding that I watch. Do I like it when the guy's on the screen? And I like it when Sean Pablo's on the screen. I enjoy watching him skate. Anyway. And Nick Stain getting obliterated by a pole. Nick Stain's really like excellent skateboarder to watch. No secret at this point. I think a lot of people have him sort of as a reference of really, really good style. So I might end up sort of fast-forwarding through some of these parts because this is sort of a montage, so not everything in this video I'm gonna have something to say about, really. It is nice to see some wide-angle fisheye action in a skate video. Another question I have, maybe somebody who is more familiar with how these skateboard cameras work than I am. Is there a reason that we only get 720p HD videos? Like, I notice a lot of videos on Thrasher, this one, they're all in 720p, which isn't really, YouTube doesn't even consider it to be HD anymore. 1080p, I guess, is really only what YouTube considers to be HD. And I think the quality loss is noticeable. Perhaps it has something to do with the kinds of cameras that people use to film skating, the frame rate being capped at 30 when you go to 1080p, is that what it is? And you can only go to 60 frames per second at 720p? I'm not sure, but if that's the case, maybe it's time to look for a newer camera that can keep up, or perhaps there's another reason that we get all these videos in 720p. It's time to put skate videos in 1080p. If we're gonna do the HD thing, in my opinion, I think we should fully do the HD thing. 720p is between standard def and full high definition. If anything, tons of videos are in 4K now. Skateboarding, we're lagging behind as usual, and I don't really see a reason to. I mean, if you're going to film VX, fine, film VX. But if you're going to film HD, film full HD. 720p, I'm ready to see full, when we get those sweet zooms on Cater's face when he's smoking weed, I want to see every pore on his face. This trick kind of stood out to me as one of the cooler ones in the montage. The nose slide on top of this housing, whatever, electrical or... I like that. There is a trend that maybe Etienne, I don't know who's responsible for this trend, but whenever you have a shorter dude, Kyoto, Etienne, this gentleman here, they love to rock the long ass jorts with half cabs. I wonder if anybody else has noticed that. Got some Rowan footy. He's, you know, skating excellently, as usual. I like Rowan. He kind of looks like he's just along for the ride, mostly. Okay, this is another thing that I was sort of thinking of. These, like, really quintessential FA hockey guys that you think about, like Aiden Mackey, Ben Cadeau. I still don't know how to pronounce that. Still haven't received proper clarification on it. I've looked up interviews, and he doesn't say his name. He doesn't say how to... He just says, hey, it's Ben. I don't know. If anybody knows, if anybody has a definite answer on how to say his last name, please let me know, because I'm quite a big fan of his skating, and it's a... I think it's a little shameful to not know how to pronounce his last name, but I have tried to do the research. Anyway, these guys, people tend to think that these dudes are sort of overrated, I think, because of how popular they are in the skate space, especially among younger skaters. But I think there's good reason. Like, when these guys are on screen, are their clips interesting, you know? I think so. So yeah, I think with this Strobeck filming, you get sort of... There's trade-offs to the way that he decides to film a trick. It's almost like when you're watching these Strobeck videos, what you're kind of getting is you're getting skateboarding, and you're also sort of getting a fashion show, which I think is appropriate as... What I think this is a Supreme montage. I think this is about showing off Supreme stuff. Like, this sort of a thumbnail is, like, half the purpose of this shot to me feels like highlighting this guy's outfit. And the other half is the skateboarding. And he manages to achieve both of them pretty well. I mean, he's had a lot of practice at it. But, yeah, I mean, I think if that is the objective to make a half fashion show, half skateboarding video, then Strobeck, he does his job very well. And there are some instances where I think he sort of misses on the skateboarding a little bit. It's gonna happen. You pay a price for this style of filming. That was pretty crazy, by the way. No complying into that, just straight up. That trick is making a little comeback, I tell you. Yeah, the back Suski grind is coming in. Sean Pablo had a couple good ones in the Candyland video. He did the back Suski backside flip out on the pyramid ledges. And ever since then, I've been doing a couple of them. And I think it's a really nice trick, quite underrated. Very busy fit. I think in this outfit right here, we've got three different patterns. You got the flannel, the bandana pattern, and then pinstripe pants. Three different patterns. Is it a drippy fit? I don't know. I'll let you guys be the judge on this one. Tyshawn's super good. So I'm a little confused on what the situation is with this burning trash can and then why he dumps it on the floor. I don't know if he is trying to aid the situation by dumping out the trash because somebody's starting a fire and he doesn't want the fire to spread. I'm not entirely sure what's going on here. I think he's trying to put it out. I think that's what's happening. I am a little bit impressed, I won't lie, about his ability to just approach a trash can and deconstruct it sort of effortlessly. It looks like this is not his first Italian trash can that he has taken apart. So yeah, I think he's trying to put out the fire, I believe. And here's another one, maybe it's that dude who's doing it? I guess he decides that he cannot save every trash can and leaves this one to burn. So that was pretty sick. Pretty damn cool. 50-50 Wally North, I guess. 50-50 Wally North. Pretty cool. I like that. Nice. I'm a little, like, here's one of the Strobeck things I think he needs to drop. Like, the pigeon obsession, the pigeon fetish, let's, I think we can leave it in the past. Listen, if it's in the same take as the actual made attempt, then I'm like, okay. I've seen Strobeck do this so many times, putting the pigeon flying and then cutting to, sort of trying to make it look like there is no cut, but there still is a cut. I'm not really a big fan of this. I wish that he would stop doing this because I think it's making his video a little bit corny. He's skirting the line so closely so many times, and by using this pigeon thing and cutting the clip, in my opinion, he's crossing the line a little bit. If you don't look at a clip like this, you probably don't notice what is actually like going on here and why it's so cool. They're all using this spot. They're not trying to get over that second ledge. They're just incorporating it into their trick. So switch front nose slide, and then he shove it, and it just bounces off that step. I mean, I think that's really sick. I think that's a super cool trick. I think that's one of the cleanest tricks I've ever seen Aiden Mackey do. This is a good look. One of the best looks in this video, I think. Side note, those Kevin Bradley shoes, I don't know how Nike decides to give people shoes, but I think these are some of the worst looking Nike shoes. Personally, I know they're all about smoking weed and stuff with the cloud, but I don't know. I just never thought these looked good. I think Nike's sort of been missing a little bit on the pro models. I think the Shane O'Neal shoes, too, were just so lame. My thought on the Shane O'Neal shoes were kind of that if you look at Shane O'Neal's Instagram, it was just obsessed with Janowskis. Every other post is him sitting down in his Janowskis or him posting his box of Janowskis. New Janowski colorway. He just is a Janowski maniac. And I mean, it makes perfect sense. Like, that shoe suited him really well. And then I think Nike was just like, this is one of our best dudes. And like, I have no idea, but it just seemed like Nike was like pressuring him or something to make a pro model shoe. And he's just like, I like the Janowski. And then just made a shoe that looks and probably skates just like the Janowski, but looks a little worse and has Shane O'Neal's name on it. So that's this what I believe is a story on that shoe. And then this Kevin Bradley shoe is just totally random. I don't really know how or why they decided to give Kevin Bradley a shoe, but I wanted to like the concept of a Velcro shoe. But I think these look pretty bad. I do like the way that Strobeck uses music in his montages. I do think like these in between sections where he pairs this music. I think that's one of the strongest things that he does. A lot of credit to him on that. I think he's got a very good ear for music and how to pair that with his montages. I don't know about the 50-50 tail slide. I'm going to be honest. I'm a big fan of her skating, Beatrice's skating, but the 50-50 front tail. It doesn't look terrible, but it kind of is, I feel. She kind of skirts the line a lot of doing illegal tricks, and most of the time I don't have a problem with it. Like, she'll do like 50-50 180s out and stuff, and they don't ever look bad to me, even though they look bad most of the time by other skaters. But the 50-50 tail slide, I don't know. That was a pretty amazing clip. These ollies in the beginning, they look like a galloping gazelle. Just some creature in its natural habitat. I don't know. Perfect as usual. That was a really impressive sequence. This was cool too. I don't think I've ever seen an ollie north nose bonk front shove it. Came out of nowhere. Came out of left field with this one, but that's pretty gnarly. Nice. So, one of the drawbacks, I think, with this filming style is tricks like this where, based off his body language, this is a pretty high rail, but it's kind of hard to tell with the way that some of this stuff is filmed. So, personally, I think there's maybe a little bit of an issue when I am making judgments on the obstacle that he's skating based off his body language and not the obstacle itself. So you get two angles here. The second one, I think, does a better job of sort of showing what he's skating, but it's a little too cropped in for my taste. I think, like I said, with this style of filming, there's trade-offs. And in this kind of situation, I think it works out for the worse and not for the better. That's a crazy good manual. This clip is kind of hilarious because I think it highlights what Tyshawn is capable of. You'll have your kind of levels in skateboarding when you look at a spot. There's a skateboarder like me who's like decent, but I can't really skate a spot the way pro or really good or am skaters or even most flow skaters can probably skate a spot. I can't really hit a spot the way that it's designed to be sort of hit. Then you got your flow, your pro, your am guys who are more or less kind of skating the spot the way that it's meant to be skated, and they skate a spot sort of to a high level of its potential. And then you have like Tyshawn who is able to skate a spot in a way that other people simply cannot just because of how extremely athletic he is. I mean, he's just jumping up this entire two block, which people skate off of. He's just going up it and then lands on this thin concrete section and then just ollies over this massive trash can. I mean, if I went to a spot, that would never, ever, ever enter my mind. And it wouldn't enter the mind of 99.9% of skateboarders. But this is just what he is able to do. Which I think is pretty amazing because this doesn't even follow any kind of traditional skateboarding line or sequence. He's kind of looking at this as, it's similar to an analogy I made about parkour with Brandon Westgate and Mason Silva, how they sort of, in my opinion, their skateboarding reminds me of parkour with the way that they skate obstacles. This is like that, but an extreme version of it. Look how he just hops up this massive two block and then just leaps. I mean, the height of this ollie is absurd. It's absurd. That's just... He's skating the spot in a way it's not even the same kind of skateboarding. This is something different. And that to me, that's pretty exciting. It's a double ollie line. When do you see a double ollie line? So I thought this clip was really cool and just shows off what he's capable of. What he's capable of is inhuman. The pure athleticism of what this guy is capable of. Like, I think that, you know, skateboarding Olympics, blah, blah, blah. Some people are talking about highest, longest should be how we do the skateboarding in the Olympics. And while I don't necessarily agree with that, I don't think that would make for an exciting competition. if that were the case, Tyshawn would just dominate everybody. I mean, this dude, this is what an Olympic athlete in the traditional sense, this is what that looks like, I think. So this is one of the areas where I think, again, the style of filming is a little bit not the best, because I think it's kind of hard to gauge exactly how big this drop is. This is sort of another instance of that. I'd be curious to see what this spot looks like filmed. Okay. Get those feet out of the frame, dude. You can lie there, but cover your feet up for fuck's sake. Okay, well, yeah, do it. Do it out of frame. Thank you. Okay. Cater weed. So I don't even really know what that transition was, but I guess it was cater with weed. So there you go. What it really does, this transition, is sort of contributes, it's kind of building towards like the three cater clips that are in this video, and it's putting cater sort of on this pedestal in this video, and it's interesting to see the way that Strobeck plays favorites a little bit with who he gives these sexy transition periods to. So I haven't seen this kid before. I'm assuming he's some Italian kid, but he is a maniac. This kid is really fucking good. Okay, why even bother filming this angle? I'm gonna be real on this one. What a weird place to film this. I don't know. That's a bit better, I think. More pigeon porn. This obsession with pigeons, man. I mean, I'm guessing he didn't even land that one because it cuts. A rare street grab. Interesting. Tweaked melon. I think this might be my favorite outfit of the skateboarding / fashion show video. Okay. This kid is so good. Nice. That was a straight high-end beat. Switch heel flip. Hewn? Is that it? Hewn? This was a hewn switch heel. Are you kidding me? That was so good. This kid looks like he's 14 years old, and that's what his switch heel flip looks like? This kid is special. I put my money on him. And you know I gotta represent my fellow Four Eyes skateboarder. Cater just looking like an adult out here. This is my man right here. I want my money on this guy, please. Beautiful. Is that a McDonald's sticker? What was that? What is that? Is that like a Supreme sticker? Why did he have a McDonald's sticker on his board? This fakie hard flip thing. What do we think, team? Is that a hard flip? Or is that a shove it? Let's take this to the slow-mo. It's so vertical. Because it doesn't actually flip around, does it? It just sort of... I don't know what that is. I have no idea what that is, but... it's something, and it's kind of cool. I'd like to hear, if you've made it this far into the video, comment below. What is that? Is it a shove it? Is it a hard flip? Does it matter? I don't have the answers. I don't have the answer to that one. I will say, I'm not fucking with those pants. Sage is like one of the hottest dudes in the game. Look at this dude. He is such a masculine beauty, and he chooses to wear these pants. I personally, they don't speak to me. With a different set of pants, I think he would just be one of the hottest dudes in the game. But these are a bit much for me. Look how vertical this is. Those pants, though, man.
What you think?
You didn't have to do my man like that on the zoom on the nose. You didn't need to do that. He did him dirty here. Putting this in. Did him real dirty. So Robeck kind of like puts Cater in this. He's one of the skaters with the least amount of clips in this video, but he uses him again and again for these hype in between beginning of the song, get ready, get stoked. Cater's gonna have one clip in this next song. He uses him a lot like this, and he can kind of get away with using Cater in this way because I think Cater's starting to be one of for some people, he's becoming a target, and he's really easy to hate on because, you know, he's acting a little crazy on Instagram Live, the whole shoe drama. And so Cater's becoming somewhat of a polarizing individual in skateboarding. And Strobeck is using him, like, to get you excited for the next portion of this video, even though he's had, like, two clips so far. Now, in my opinion, I don't love it, but I'm not going to say, oh, you can't do that, or he shouldn't be doing that. Because here's the thing about Cater skateboarding. Every time this guy pops up in a new video, he gets better and better and better. For all the shit Cater might be doing off camera, or a pain in whoever's side, in Andrew Reynolds' side, skating an anti-hero board for no fucking reason, just doing a bunch of shit to piss a lot of people off. I mean, look at this guy. Who's gonna tell him what to do? Who's gonna tell you what to do when this is what your back tail looks like? I'm sorry, he's too fucking good. Oh my god, dude, he is too good. All this weed smoking and stuff and all these, like, antics, you'd expect him to, like, I don't know, it would be such an easy narrative to be like, oh, Cater's going off the rails, Cater's blowing it, he's burning out. I don't know, like, but this dude he's not going anywhere. I don't care how much weed he smokes every day. Is it 1 pound, 2 pounds, 3 pounds? It doesn't fucking matter. If he can do this... Like, how easy did that look for him? How easy did that look? I know that's probably not what a lot of people want to hear, that I think Cater's really fucking good, and I don't really care what he does, as long as he keeps skating as well as he does. But that's how I feel about it. Like, and he has the last trick in this video for good reason. We'll get to it. Everything Cater does on camera is like gold. Every trick he does that I see is gold. He's one of the most talented dudes in skating right now. And you can't take that away from him. No matter how he behaves. Jeez, this ledge, by the way, just got obliterated by these dudes. And these ladies. This lady. The ledge got obliterated by this group of skateboarders. This crook is nuts. That's so long and chunky at the end there. Dude, look, it doesn't get better than this. My mouth dropped when I first saw that, and it dropped again because of how perfect that nose slide kickflip was. I have nothing to say. Switch front board. Show is dope. Shit. Pretty fucked. This spot is gnarly. Like, I don't even think that Strobeck does a good job of even highlighting how gnarly this spot is. But this spot is gnarly. Crazy. It's huge. So that's it. That's the video. And then we just have B-roll of teenagers smoking weed and filming each other smoking weed and stuff. So yeah. That's the video. Everybody in skateboarding is talented now, and there's a few guys who really, really stand out, and I think Cater is just a really, really special talent. In terms of this video, I don't know. It's a good video. I'm a little bit, like, over the Strobeck formula. I'm not going to enjoy this as much as a lot of other people are, though I think this video is probably going to do its job for advertising Supreme, doing the fashion show. Whole thing, but you know, do I love this video? Not really. It's a lot of like filler tricks. There's some nice tricks in here. There's not even really a point of like rating this video or anything like that, because it's not trying to be a traditional skate video. It's doing something else. But I enjoy these videos. But I have my reservations with these kinds of videos, like I do any other kinds of videos. And no, I won't hate on FA or hockey pointlessly just because they're popular, and I encourage you guys to not do the same thing. There's plenty of shit in skateboarding that is more worthy of your disapproval than these videos. These videos are far from whack, in my opinion. They're not my favorite things in the world, but I don't need to see teenagers smoking weed and having like sexual tension with other teenagers behind the teenagers. I just don't need that in my skate videos. That's not why I'm here. If I want to watch Gummo or something, or kids or a movie like that, I'll watch that movie. It's just not what I look for in my skate videos. I think if you're a teenager and you're into skateboarding, these sorts of B-roll clips are probably exciting and cool to you. Like I said, not for me. Thanks for watching, guys. This is sort of my take on the whole Stallion thing. There's things I like about it and things I don't like about it, but mostly I like it, I guess. So anyway, yeah, I've been recording for an hour, and I think I'm ready to fucking stop. So yep, see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching.